For us, the blending is indeed the possibility to reach out to many more small and medium enterprises, to inspire young entrepreneurs to come forward, and at the same time to help venture capital funds to flourish here in Europe. Hi, I'm Hubert Cotoni, responsible for fundraising at the European Investment Fund. Today, EIF talks blending European resources, doing more together. Europe is a complicated place. If we, as the European Investment Fund, the EIF, are being asked to create programs and initiatives in support of small and medium enterprise in Europe, there's always the big question popping up. Do we do this Europe-wide, or do we go regional, do we go local? And I guess there's not a clear-cut answer to this. Because if we were to go Europe-wide, we might ignore regional specificities. And at the same time, if we were to go regional, we might indeed suffer enormous insufficiencies, which, given the budgets in Europe, we should never risk. But the good thing and the good message today for you is there's a third way, and we call this blending. Now, blending resources can be done in various ways. The first way is to blend various initiatives together. However, what we see in the market today is that indeed every single member state is trying to cook its own little soup by creating a support scheme for small enterprises, for instance, in Hungary, whilst the Austrian neighbor is trying to do exactly the same for their small enterprises, leading to enormous inefficiencies, leading to enormous bureaucracies, as different procedures have to be applied, different eligibility criteria have to be applied. And so therefore, we are asking, why don't we bring this all together? There are European schemes, I'm not bothering with names, but there's COSME, there's INNOFIN, there's European-wide aid schemes, financing schemes for small and medium enterprises, which you could easily join with your regional or national monies. So rather than creating something from scratch, join this market-oriented solution, which is there for you to be used, rather than risking inefficiencies, bureaucracies, a lot of audit requirements. That is one offer which we can provide to you today. The second way to blend is indeed with money. The money in the public domain is available at regional level, at member state level, at European level. And if we combine this, bring this all together, we can easily mobilize funding from the European Investment Bank or the European Investment Fund. Now, I would like to give an example what we did more recently in the Baltic States. The creation of a regional fund of fund, which was investing into venture capital funds in Latvia, Estonia, and Lithuania, brought about an enormous success. These funds today, they flourish in an enormous way and were able to attract private capital in a manner we haven't seen before. We were able to attract pension funds and insurance companies, private investors, which up to this moment in time were not ready for this asset class. But today, they are serious partners in our fund of funds. If I look at the ecosystem, the venture capital ecosystem and landscape today in these three countries, it's flourishing. And it is flourishing, why? Because on first hand, this fund of fund was able to support newly entering venture capital funds, was helping their fundraising. On the other hand, it was able to mobilize funding for a well-established fund to scale up their financing. And this brings me to the third point. It's the private investors. We, the European Investment Fund, we have access to the best performing venture capital funds in Europe. We know that the private investors are looking at us, they're following us, because we are considered as market-based, market-oriented investors. So they like joining us. And this is the opportunity as public and private investors to bring this all together in order to support the small and medium enterprises in their bringing up, but more importantly, when they scale up, when they need capital most, and in order to keep them in Europe, we have to be able to follow them all the way through to have them firmly settled in Europe and not going off to America or China. 20 years ago, Europe didn't have a venture capital market to talk about. 10 years ago, the financial crisis hit the world, and Europe was particularly hard hit. Looking at the banks, they literally stopped lending to small and medium enterprises. Blending allows us to take more risks, allows us to really reach out to many more SMEs, able to attract many more financial intermediaries in our mission to support small and medium enterprises in Europe. And when small and medium enterprises flourish, we all benefit. Thank you.